Remember, in Foucault's concept of the disciplinary society, the human subjects are habituated and shaped through several forms of disciplining institutions, such as the workplace, the school, and the prison. The people enforcing the discipline, such as workplace managers and school teachers, and their corresponding systems of conducts and regulations, are therefore situated within specific spatial confines. Since the middle of the 20th century, however, the gradual expansion of information technologies to every aspect of life began to change this spatially limited arrangement of discipline. Realized by this ubiquitous computing, the operations of discipline became despatialized or delinked from the material confines of architectures, such as the school or the office buildings. This new model was named by the philosopher Joe Deleuze in 1990 as control society, the core technology of which could be summed up as a sensorial, inactionable database. This database performs what disciplining institutions, such as schools, were always already doing, which is the sorting of the human subjects according to a set of classifications and the treatment of each group by different actions. In a school context, for example, this may mean things like the A grade, the B grade, the failing grade, being absent or present in class, and so on. And by extension, one would experience the control society through being in or out of eligibility or access. Such as, if your grades are good enough to be eligible for a certain university, or which tier of healthcare you could access based on your national or company standings. Therefore, going beyond the disciplining of the body toward productive ends, control shapes the body's possibility to varying zones. Or, from a different angle, the logic of control liquefies the solid disciplinary architectures into networks of checkpoints and enforcers. In the same paper, Deleuze cited his partner in crime Félix Guattari's fictional city, a city composed of sensor networks positioned at strategic checkpoints between zones, serving to identify the access privileges of people's electronic cards, letting some in and keeping others out. Building on Deleuze's control society concept, Hagerty and Erickson in 2000 observed the emergence of a form of identity composed entirely by data, such as school grades, criminal records, credit ratings, shopping records, likes, clicks, and so on. They named it Data Double, which is you as the ghost-like composition of your records and classifications in databases. Databases that sort and give people differential treatments accordingly. The security checkpoints in airports would be an example of this sorting. Or less obviously, the bank functions as a checkpoint for sorting people with higher credit ratings to be given mortgage.